No, it's all bit. Well, try this one. You don't like that?
No.
Do you ever eat steamed crabs?
We have Nolly.
That's what we call steamed crabs.
That stuff's very, very spicy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not know. That stuff, you know.
It's good.
Munching on that, the old bay.
It's you.
Thank you.
for tonight's game. First up, the Losing York Revolution, leading off, right fielder number one, Shannon Wilkerson. Shortstop number four, Eric Patterson. At left field, number 36, Nick Bergman. Second baseman, number 7, Andres Perez. Designated hitter, number 16, Jacob Palmerone. At first base, number 38, Delvin Nash. The catcher, number 34, Salvador Peñagua. Center fielder, number 12, Sean Smith. At third baseman, number 21, Wilson Valdez. On the mound for Disney Revolution, the right-handed pitcher, number 18, Anthony LaRue.
Let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups brought to you by Guardian Pest Control. First for the York Revolution, coming in with a record of 21-38 in fourth place in the Freedom Division. Shannon Wilkerson, the right fielder, will lead things off. The shortstop, Eric Patterson, is batting second. Nick Ferdinand is the left fielder, and he bats third. Andres Perez is the second baseman, and he is batting fourth. Batting fifth is Jacob Calderon, and he is the designated hitter. Delvin Nash bats sixth and plays first base. Salvador Peñagua is the catcher, and he bats seventh. Sean Smith is batting eighth and playing center field, and batting ninth and playing third base is Wilson Valdez. The lineup now for the Blue Crabs, 33-25, first place in the Freedom Division. Fred Lewis, the right fielder, will lead things off. Casey Stevenson is the third baseman. He bats second. Zach Wilson is batting third. He's the first baseman. Gustavo Molina is catching, and he is batting fourth. Darryl Ward is the DH. He bats fifth. Jake Opitz is the second baseman, and he is batting sixth. Batting seventh, playing left field, is Jovan Rosa. Jamar Walton is playing center field. He bats eighth. And Casey Frawley is batting ninth and playing shortstop. Blue Crabs home whites tonight. White jerseys, white pants. Blue Crabs lettering across the chest. Blue numbers on the backs with the baby blue caps and the navy blue brims. And they are positioned in the third base side dugout, managed by Stan Clyburn in his first season. For the Revolution tonight, they are in their road grays with black numbers on the backs, black caps, and they are situated in the first base side dugout, managed by Mark Mason in his third season managing the York Revolution. Our umpires tonight, behind the plate, is Donald Mayer. Christopher Kiersarski is the first base umpire. Kevin Sweeney is the third base umpire. A three umpiring crew here tonight. Outdoor Creations brings us our Regency Furniture Stadium field dimensions. It's 310 down the left field line, 325 to the corner down the right field line, 375 to the alleyway in left center, 385 to the alleyway in right center, 405 from home plate to the 12-foot high fence covered by a dark green tarp in straightaway center field. The Mini Monster painted in green in left field with the manual scoreboard right in the center painted in white. The big video board behind the mini grass hill in right center field. Beautiful green grass in the outfield. Beautiful green grass in the infield. And the infield dirt, as always, manicured to perfection. The maroon gravel warning track surrounding the outer edge of the ballpark, and as always, great job by the grass kickers, our grounds crew, for getting this field prepped and ready to go and looking beautiful as always. Time for tonight's Honest Exterior Olympic Air weather report. It's mostly cloudy, 84 degrees, winds 3 miles per hour to the southwest. We hope that The rain does hold off here tonight. There is some possible rain about an hour away in the forecast, but hopefully it either blows over or just drizzles to the point where there won't be any stoppage in play. And, of course, if there is a delay, hopefully it's not too long. We don't have another washout as we did the other night. These two teams were forced to play a doubleheader last night because of the rain out on Tuesday. Hopefully that weather does stay away. Either way, though, that bad weather, the rainy weather, if you will, that wet thunderstorm weather that's coming this way, it's not going to be as nasty as that weather was on Tuesday. Boy, that was at times very scary and pretty nasty as well. We'll take one final break, and when we come back, we'll give you the player to bank on and our final look at tonight's ball game as we get you set for Game 3 of this series between the York Revolution and the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. This is the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs pregame show on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Etrepid. A fabulous job by Ellen Nelson singing our national anthem here tonight. Our player to bank on is brought to you by the Community Bank of the Chesapeake. Since returning from the disabled list, infielder Casey Frawley is 10 for 21 at the plate. Casey also is in the middle of a 7-game hitting streak and is hitting .476 in his last 10 games. Tonight's Community Bank of the Chesapeake player to bank on is outfielder Casey Stevenson. Blue Crabs are 33-25, first place in the Freedom Division. Revolution 21-38. That does it for the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs pregame show. We'll have the first pitch for you between the York Revolution and the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. And Game 3 of the set next on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Etrepid.
Chien-Ming Wang.
Blue Crabs have taken the field defensively from left to right in the outfield. Rosa, Walton, Lewis. Stevenson's at third. Frawley's at short. Opitz at second. Wilson is at first. Molina's behind the plate. And on the mound, making his Atlantic League debut tonight, former major leaguer Chien-Ming Wang. Our first pitch tonight is presented by Charlotte Hall Veterans Home, as Shannon Wilkerson will lead things off. The right fielder, Shannon, 273 average with a home run and 12 RBIs. Wilkerson bats on the right side against the righty, Wong. First base edge of the rubber. He rocks, kicks, and fires. A fastball, a called strike across the knees, and we are underway. Right on time, 7:05, first pitch, Eastern Time. When picking up here at the ballpark, it'll be Wilkerson, Patterson, and Ferdinand. As Wong slowly into the wind, here comes an 0-1. Swing and a miss, and it's nothing in two. Chien was signed after being released by the Braves organization on June 19th. He was signed just a couple of days ago by the Blue Crabs, making his first start since the 17th of June. 2-6 in the International League with a 6.10 ERA. In 11 games, he's thrown 62 innings here this year. The windup and the two-strike pitch. Swing and a bouncer foul of third. 96 hits, 46 runs, 42 of those runs earned, 28 walks, and 21 strikeouts. 122 wins to his name in his professional career combined between the major leagues and the minor leagues. He's got that slow pace as he lifts his hands above his hat, pauses, now kicks in the 0-2. Swing and a ground ball back towards the middle. Opitz to his right, gets in front of it, sidearms to first, and Wilkerson is out number one. Good start for Chien-Ming Wang, who is 35 years of age, 6'4", 225 pounds. Eric Patterson will come to the plate. The shortstop hitting a 222 with four home runs and 19 RBIs. No score top first. Infant stages of this ball game. Lights begin to come on here at the ballpark. Patterson bats from the left side. Two former major leaguers going at it here. Wong versus Patterson. First base edge of the rubber for Chien-Ming Wang. Slowly rocks, kicks, and fires. Swing and a line drive into right. Lewis to his left, charging in. Makes a one-hand catch in stride near the line. And that's quickly two retired by Chien-Ming Wang here in the top of the first inning. Patterson hit that one hard as he wrapped that line drive to right field. Lewis able to run it down. Fred last night making an error on a similar play that he tried to run down. He tried to make a basket belt-high catch, but he dropped the baseball. Later in that inning, the Revolution in Game 2 scored a couple of runs, winning last night in Game 2, 5-1. Blue Crabs did win Game 1 last night by the final of 8-3. Two outs, nobody on. The batter is Nick Ferdinand, who homered last night. Here's the pitch. Taken low. Nick, the left fielder, with his sixth home run last night, 11 RBIs, a .351 batting average, comes in on an 11-game hitting streak. He's on fire right now. In fact, he comes into the ballgame hitting .349 during this 11-game hitting streak. The 1-0. There's a called strike, a fastball at the knees on the inner half. A ball and a strike. Wong, of course, spent the bulk of his major league career with the New York Yankees. Won 55 games with the Yankees. Here comes a 1-1. Swing and a miss. Good movement on that off-speed pitch. And it's one ball and two strikes. Wong, guy who's got a fastball, a slider, a changeup. He's also got a splitter, sometimes that power sinker, which actually was one of his number one pitches when he was in his prime. He's got that split finger fastball he also occasionally uses as well. The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a slow roller foul, third base side. Talking with Stan Clyburn before the game in Clyburn's corner, he began to talk a little bit about what kind of pitches that Wong throws. And of course, that repertoire is not as big as it once was when he was younger. But he still has that fastball and a couple of those off-speed pitches. And he will break out that split-finger fastball as well. And sometimes that power sinker. The 1-2 pitch. Swinging a slow roller towards third. Stevenson charges. Gloves on the cut of the grass. Off-balance throw to first is in time. Nice play by Casey Stevenson. And a nice job by Chien-Ming Wang as he sets down the Revolution in order. 1-2-3. We head to the bottom of the first. Blue Crabs coming to bat. Scoreless ball game here at Regency Furniture Stadium. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Bottom of the first inning, no score. Blue Crabs coming to bat. From left to right in the outfield, Ferdinand Smith Wilkerson. Valdez is at third. Patterson at short. Perez is at second. Nash is at first. Paniagua's behind the plate. On the mound is the right-hander, Anthony LaRue. 3-3 on the season with a 3.61 ERA. This is 12th start, 57 and a third innings pitched. Opponents hitting 243. Here's the pitch. And a fastball poured in a little bit low for ball one. Ready on lefty matchup, it'll be Lewis Stevenson Wilson. Fred, 228 average, a home run, 16 RBIs, as the next offering is a little bit inside, and it's 2-0. LaRue works at a quick pace, much different from Chien-Ming Wang, who works a lot slower. Here's the 2-0. Swing and a bouncing ball, right side. The first baseman Nash to his right, scoops it up, takes it to the bag, and Lewis is retired for out number one. That'll send Casey Stevenson to the plate. LaRue is a guy who, while he works quickly, very quick-paced, his windup is also very quick as well. He barely steps back. In fact, he kind of just turns on the rubber, quickly lifts the leg, and then delivers home. Wang is basically the complete opposite, where he steps back and then slowly lifts the arms and then slowly kicks the leg and delivers. Here's the pitch to Stevenson. Casey takes a fastball for a strike across the knees on the inside corner. Casey at 307 with two home runs and 23 RBIs. Bats from the left side. No score, bottom first. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup. And Stevenson out in front. And it's quickly nothing in two. So the 12th start of the season for LaRue. 3-3. ERA okay, 3.61. The 0-2. Called, third strike, hitting the inside corner. Down goes Stevenson. And that'll send Zach Wilson to the plate. It really hasn't been one thing that you can point to why the Revolution have struggled this year. Again, here's a team that comes in 21-38, last place in the Freedom Division. At times it's been the pitching, at times it's been the hitting. They've left runners on base. Their batting average with runners in scoring position has not been very good. It's never been one thing. Pitch to Wilson's a strike over the outside corner. Zach, right-handed hitter. 271 average, two home runs, 18 RBI. LaRue kicks and fires. Swing and a fly ball right center field. Could it be trouble? Smith Wilkerson back into the alleyway. It's going to touch down on the track and one hop off the wall in right center field. Wilson around first on his way to second. Stops there with a stand-up double. Zach Wilson with the first hit of the ball game for Southern Maryland. He doubled last night. He also had three RBIs in game one of the doubleheader last night. And he's in scoring position with two outs. Blue Crabs looking to take an early lead. No score. Bottom of the first, here is Gustavo Molina. Molina, the catcher, at 290. Nine home runs. He has driven in 30 runs. Righty on righty, the pitch. Taken for a called strike, clipping the outside corner. Outfielders play deep all the way around for Molina, who with those nine home runs is tied for the league lead in that category. He's also fifth in RBIs with those aforementioned 30 runs driven in. The 0-1. Swing and a drive down the left field line, hooking foul and out of play. Boy, Molina a little bit out in front of that changeup that was left up by LaRue and certainly had home run distance. And he straightens that thing out. That's a two-run shot. 0-2 the count, two outs. Wind picking up here at the ballpark. Righty on righty matchup. The kick, the pitch. In the dirt, smothering block to his right by Panegua. And it's a ball and two strikes. Molina also coming into the game second in slugging percentage at 490. Wilson the lead off first. The 1-2. Way outside, a fastball. And it's two balls and two strikes. On deck, Darryl Ward. Last night, the Blue Crabs in game one, 11 hits, but only five hits in game number two. Really struggled offensively. It was like pulling teeth in that second game. LaRue's 2-2. Swing and a line drive straightaway center. Smith started back, now jogs in, and makes a one-hand grab in medium depth center for out number three. Blue Crabs strand a runner at second base. We move to the second, scoreless Revolution Blue Crabs. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, presented by eTrepid. Chien-Ming Wang throwing his warm-up tosses. We head to the top of the second here at Regency Furniture Stadium. The Revolution and the Blue Crabs are scoreless here tonight in Southern Maryland. The rubber match of this three-game series, both teams splitting the doubleheader last night. Revolution come in with a record of 21-38, looking to win the series. Fourth place in the Freedom Division, 12.5 games out of first place. Blue Crabs on the other side, 33-25. First place in the division with their magic number currently sitting at six games. It'll be 4-5-6 after Chien-Ming Wang set down the Revolution in order in the top of the first. Perez, Calderon, and Nash. Second baseman number seven, Perez, the second baseman at 260 with three home runs and 27 RBIs. Bats from the right side. And Wong, the right-hander on the first base edge, slowly lifts the arms, kicks, and deals. Swinging a ground ball to short. Frawley charges, scoops it on the glove side, steadies, and fires to first. One pitch, one out here in the top of the second inning. Affordable Refuse and Recycling is a full-service refuse hauler located just off the Washington, D.C. Beltway in Upper Marlboro, Maryland, servicing Prince George's County and Southern Maryland, including Charles County, St. Mary's County, and Calvert County. Affordable Refuse, where we take pride in our profession. The batter is Calderon, the DH. And the pitch from Wong, taken for a called strike, thigh high. Jacob at 296, one home run, and five RBIs. Bats from the left side, one out, no score here in the top of the second inning. Outfielder shade towards right center, 0-1. Fastball darts off the outside corner. One ball and one strike. Wong had An impressive five seasons overall with the Yankees. You know, he finished 2006 and 2007 with 19 wins. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a cue shot, dribbler left side, Stevenson from third. Bare hands on the grass, off the fingertips. And Calderon safe at first. Stevenson had it in his hand, it looked like, and at least his fingertips, but then he dropped it immediately after. And it's an infield single for the Revolution, first hit of the ballgame. For York, Telvin Nash will come to the plate. Yeah, you know, in 2006 and 2007, along with those 19 wins, was tied for first and second in the American League in that category, respectively. He also finished second in the Cy Young Award voting in 2006 to Johan Santana. Nash, the first baseman at 3 for 23 here this season. Bats from the right side. The pitch taken low, smothered by Molina. And it's ball one. Mentioned some other accolades, if you will, for Wang. The guy who was at the top of the Yankee rotation in 2008. Remember, that rotation consisted of Andy Pettitte and Mike Mussina. One out. 1-0. Cut on. Foul tip in and out of the mid of Molina. And it's one ball and one strike. He also became the first starter in the new Yankee Stadium in an exhibition game against the Chicago Cubs on April 3rd of 2009. I actually remember that night. It was very, very misty and cold. I remember at the time I was living up in the Northeast. And it was very ugly night. We'll put it that way. 1-1. Swing and a bouncing ball in the hole left side. Out of the range of Frawley. And in the left field right between Stevenson and Frawley. As Rosa fields it cleanly, stopping at second is Calderon. Back-to-back hits, little cue shot infield single by Jacob Calderon. And now Telvin Nash with his fourth hit of the year. And a threat here for the Revolution. Scoreless game, top of the second, first and second. And that'll send Salvador Panegua to the plate. Panegua, 170 average with a home run, 11 RBIs. Righty-on-righty matchup. Hope it's pinched towards second. A high set. Here's the pitch. Swinging a ground ball to short. Could be two. Frawley scoops. Flips the second one. Opens his turn. On to first. Is in time. A double play. Nicely done. 6-4-3. And that does it for the little rally by the Revolution. No runs, two hits, two men left. To the home half of the second. York nothing. Blue Crabs nothing. You're listening to the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network presented by eTrepid. Bottom of the frame here in the second inning. Scoreless ball game. Revolution and the Blue Crabs at Regency Furniture Stadium here tonight. Darryl Ward will lead things off. It'll be Ward Opitz Rosa. Anthony LaRue, the right-hander, finished his warm-up tosses and ready to begin inning number two. Rubber match of this three-game series. Blue Crabs come in having won four of their last five. Darryl Ward, left-handed hitter, the DH, .244 average with a home run and 10 RBIs. Here's the pitch. Ward takes a called strike over the inside corner. Jake opens to hit next. Outfielder's deep all the way around. The pitch on the way. Change up a little bit low. And it's one ball and one strike. The Blue Crabs making a couple of moves here today as they send Tyler Wagner to the inactive list. 1-1. Down and in. And, of course, after signing Chien-Ming Wang, they immediately activated him. It's been a flurry of moves for the Blue Crabs, 2-1. And a called strike right there at the knees on the outer third. Really the last week and a half for Southern Maryland. There's been five or six moves here. A couple of guys have come and gone. As always happens here with every team in the Atlantic League. The 2-2. Down and in, full counts. On deck, Jake Opitz. Wilson Valdez well off the line at third. In fact, he's closer to the hole on the left side than he is his actual position. Pitch. Swing and a bouncer to first. Nash collects it on two hops, drops it, picks it up with a glove, and flips it easily to LaRue to record the outs. It was ugly, but got the job done. 3-1 on the put out. And here's Jake Opitz. Yeah, Nash collected it, and then just as he started to run towards the bag, he dropped the baseball. And then he did what you really shouldn't do. He picked it up with his glove, snow cone style, and then was able just to easily flip it to LaRue, who was doing his job in covering the bag. Jake Opitz, the hitter, the second baseman, bats from the left side, .230 average, four home runs, 10 driven in, and he takes a fastball for a strike at the knees. And LaRue, a guy, as we mentioned in the first, working quickly here. And he's very efficient, throwing a lot of strikes, an 0-1. Swing and a fly ball, straightaway center, medium depth. Smith freezing, takes two steps in, and makes a two-hand catch at the brim of the cap. Two outs, nobody on. Here is Jovan Rosa. Rosa, the left fielder, at .339. Two home runs, 11 RBIs. He's really been swinging a hot bat since being picked up from Bridgeport. He was actually released by the Bluefish not too long ago. And he was signed by the Blue Crabs almost immediately after Kyle Hankard left for Mexico. And he's given that boost that lineup needed, the pitch. Swing and a ball shot foul over the dugout on the first base side into the seats. Rosa signed as a free agent by the Blue Crabs on June 7th. Played just 17 games for Bridgeport, hitting .186 with five RBIs. Night and day with how he's playing here. Here's a swing and a pop foul off to the right and out of play. By the way, you hear that Christmas music in the background. That music is embedded underneath the actual walkout songs for these players because it's halfway to Christmas night here at Regency Furniture Stadium. The 0-2. Just missed off the inside corner, and it's one ball and two strikes. Blue Crabs, in their last homestand against Camden, actually wore those ugly Christmas sweater-type jerseys. Tonight, just the regular white jerseys. 1-2. Down the way, two balls and two strikes. Great job by the entire crew here of the Blue Crabs as they try to give the fans that feel of Christmas. Halfway there. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Called third strike over the inside corner. Rosa didn't like it. And that's the second strikeout for Anthony LaRue. He sets the Blue Crabs down in order as we head to the top half of the third inning. York and Southern Maryland scoreless on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Top of the third, scoreless game, the Revolution and the Blue Crabs. York, Southern Maryland, rubber match of this three-game set. Chien-Ming Wang ready to begin inning number two. Revolution with two hits off Wang. Blue Crabs with a hit off opposing starter Anthony LaRue. It'll be 8-9-1, Sean Smith, Wilson Valdez, and then back to the top of the order, and Shannon Wilkerson. Smith, the center fielder, hitting at 200 with a home run and two RBIs. He bats from the right side. He's got the pants rolled up to the knees, showing off the navy blue socks here tonight. A righty-on-righty matchup. Wang slowly into the line. And now the pitch on the way. Smith, showing bunt late, pulls back and takes low. Stevenson even with the bag at third. Smith, the guy who, while he was recovering from that injury that he suffered on a home run that was hit in late September last year, he was recovering from that in the offseason. Here's a 1-0, swing and a miss. And he took his wife and son to the Cheesecake Factory to honor Jackie Robinson's birthday. And she wasn't sure if he was going to continue playing after that injury. Thought maybe, you know, I'm 32 years old, this might be it. Well, the bill came, and it was exactly $42, the number of Jackie Robinson on his birthday. 1-1. A called strike, clipping the outside corner. Well, Sean took that as a sign, and he knew that, you know what, I'm going to play one more year. I'm destined to give it one more try, and here he is. He recovered from injury. He missed part of the season in the beginning, but here he is in a Revolution uniform. 1-2. Swing and a slow roller left side. Wang off the mound. Backhand grab. Sidearms to first. A chest-high throw to Wilson. And Smith is erased for out number one. That'll send Wilson Valdez to the plate. Valdez, the third baseman at 249. Zero home runs, 12 RBIs. Bats from the right side. Wilson, 37 years of age. Guy who you can just tell has so much fun playing the game of baseball. In fact, in batting practice today, when the Revolution were taking BP, Wilson was trying to hit home runs. Wang slowly into the wind. Here comes the pitch. Taken for a called strike across the knees. I know hitting coaches out there listening are cringing at me saying that right now, but he made a bet with his teammates during BP when he was taking batting practice, saying, I bet you I can hit one over the fence. He kept missing, and he said, okay, this next one I'm hitting over the fence. Well, he got good wood on the next pitch, and what happened was it hit right off the top of the mini monster, the 0-1. Swinging a foul off to the right and out of play, and it's nothing in two. Well, after hitting it off the top of the mini monster, everybody out there for the Revolution during BP just erupted in laughter. It was a great, great moment. It was one of the fun moments for what has been an otherwise very unsuccessful first half of the season for the Revolution. No score, top third, one out. The two-strike pitch in the dirt. And it's a ball and two strikes with Shannon Wilkerson waiting on deck. Blue Crabs the 7-2 advantage over the Revolution here this season. Five of those ball games have been played in York. Long into the wind. Here comes a 1-2 pitch. Cut on. A foul tip at the plate. Rolling to the backstop. Lights on here at the ballpark. Some blue sky up above trying to peek through the gray and hazel clouds. No threatening clouds as of yet. We hope that the rain holds off here. Rosa deep in left, about 5 feet from the track. Walton medium depth center. Lewis medium depth right. The 1-2 pitch. Down the way. Two balls, two strikes is the count. Valdez, a guy who was signed by the Montreal Expos as an amateur free agent way back in 1997. You know, you get up and close to Wilson Valdez, this guy looks like he's 25 years old. I mean, he really, really looks good for his age. Obviously, all professional athletes do for their age, but Valdez certainly does not look 37. This guy is in great shape. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Swung on, bounced to third. Stevenson charges, gloves it on two hops, shuffles the feet, throws to first from the cut of the grass. And Valdez out number two. 4-3 on the putout. Two outs, base is empty. Back to the top of the order. And here is Shannon Wilkerson. Blackstone Management, located right here in Waldorf, is a full-service real estate management firm operating residentially and commercial properties along with homeowners associations all over the U.S. The company focuses primarily on the world's most competitive and lucrative real estate markets with years of experience under their belts. Visit BlackstoneManagement.com to learn more. Wilkerson 0-1. He grounded out to the second baseman. Opitz his first time. No score here in the top of the third. Two outs. Outfielders play straight away. Wong on the first base edge. Turns, kicks. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball down and away. We're getting a chance to see that repertoire, which at one point in the career of Chien-Ming Wang was very large. Fastball, slider, changeup, splitter, power sinker, split finger fastball, as we mentioned. But the one thing I can put my finger on, which I know is correct, is pitches tonight, from where I'm sitting and what I've seen, have a lot of movement on them. Here's a 1-0. Swinging a soft liner out to second. Opitz leaps and makes a one-hand catch on the back edge of the dirt. That's four straight retired by Chien-Ming Wang as the Revolution are retired in order 1-2-3. We head to the home half of the third inning. York and Southern Maryland scoreless. This is the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Mark Walton will lead things off bottom of the frame here in the third inning. Scoreless game, Revolution and the Blue Crabs. Anthony LaRue, third inning of work. He's allowed just one hit. He has struck out two as well. And the first offering is waved at and missed by Walton, way out in front of a changeup. Tomorrow, the center fielder, 293 with a home run, 18 RBIs. 8-9-1, Walton Frawley Lewis. Here's the pitch. In tight towards the hands of Walton, who jerks back out of the way. One ball and one strike. The pitch. Outside. Walton hitting .310 in his last 10 games. Guys, we mentioned he's been so reliable. There's a 2-1. Swing and a miss. 2-2. He's played all three outfield positions this year. And he's played the bulk of center field with Anton DeJesus on the disabled list. With a broken foot, the 2-2. Swing and a line drive over the head of the leaping Nash and down the right field line heading towards the corner. Walton digging for second. Wilkerson up with it. His throw is cut off on the right side. And Walton in safely standing with a leadoff double. Second hit for the Blue Crabs. Both hits here in the ballgame have been doubles. The first one by Wilson in the first. Now Walton with a leadoff double here in the third. Here's Casey Frawley. And Casey up there in an RBI chance, hitting at .247 this year. A home run, 13 RBIs. Raleigh hitting under .200 this year, though, with runners in scoring position. Righty on righty matchup. The pitch on the way. Squares to bunt and spins out of the way of a fastball up and in. You know, Casey, remember, he was on the disabled list. because he got hit in the head. And after he got hit in the head, when the team got back to the hotel, when they were on the road in Long Island, he had a lot of swelling. And actually, it was kind of scary for some people. So he was on the disabled list with that concussion. Squares to bunt here, drops it down. Left side, Valdez charges from third. He gloves it on the grass and throws on to first with Perez, the second baseman, covering. Up to third goes Walton. Small ball by the Blue Crabs. Sacrifice bunt successful by Casey Frawley. But yeah, I mean, when you have a pitch that's coming at you like that, when you're squared around to bunt, that's scary. And Casey did everything he could to get out of the way. And luckily, that fastball missed him. Next pitch, he dropped down the bunt, moving Walton up to third. Back to the top of the order, here's Fred Lewis. Fred grounding out to the first baseman, Nash. His first time infielders in. The pitch taken outside for ball one. Walton led off things with a double. Lewis bats from the left side. Quickly back in there. Outfielders deep all the way around. Here's the set position, the 1-0. In tight at the belt. And it's 2-0 here to Fred, who was 3-for-6 here in the series. Through comes set, 2-0. Swing and a bouncer foul outside of first. For Fred, it's been night and day at the plate at home as compared to on the road. He's hitting 273 here at Regency Furniture Stadium with 7 RBIs. On the road, he actually has 9 RBIs and a home run, but he's hitting just 188. Infielders in, one out, the 2-1. Swinging a ground ball to second. Gloved on the grass by Perez. Comes home with a throw. Here's the tag. And Walton is out. And Jamar arguing with the call with home plate umpire Donald Mayer. That throw a little bit high. It pulled Peniagua up off the plate. He caught it, came back down, and quickly applied the tag to Jamar Walton, who is arguing here and being held back by Jeremy Owens, the third base coach. Stan Clyburn out of the dugout, disagreeing vehemently with Donald Mayer. And those two are relatively close to one another, talking things out. Now the meeting between Stan and Donald is over. Stan walking back briskly to the third base side dugout. None too happy. Walton breaking from third, and he is out. Perez gloving that one on the cut of the grass. A little bit of a high throw. Nearly disaster for the Revolution. Lewis reaches on the fielder's choice. There's two outs. Here's Casey Stevenson. The pitch. And Stevenson takes a called strike at the knees. I'll tell you what, Jamar Walton, if he wasn't held back by Jeremy Owens, there was a chance he might have gotten ejected because he wasn't stopping. He continued to talk and talk and talk very loudly to home plate umpire Donald Mayer. The 0-1. Swing and a bouncing ball. Diving is LaRue with a backhand pick. Nicely done right in front of the mound. Pops up and flips it overhand to first. And he fields his position very well on that bouncer right back to him. No runs, a hit, one man left, and the Blue Crabs wasting a leadoff double from Jamar Walton. At the end of three innings of play, York and Southern Maryland scoreless. You're listening to the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. I will, like usual. All right, see ya. Thank you. Top of the fourth inning, we're scoreless. The Revolution and the Blue Crabs on the Etrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Etrepid, empowering business to communicate with clarity. And we thank you those to watching on the YouTube side of things as well. Eric Patterson leads things off. Here's the pitch from Wong. Swinging a foul off the mask of Molina, ricocheting to the screen behind the plate. Patterson flying out to the right fielder, Fred Lewis, his first time. Each team two hits apiece, both starting pitchers, Wong and LaRue, doing a nice job here tonight. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss. LaRue on the other side has thrown 38 pitches. Wong has worked three innings, now three plus. He's not walked anybody. He also has not struck out any hitters. The 0-2 pitch. Called, third strike. I spoke too soon. Fastball at the knees, down goes Patterson. Eric 0 for 2. And the first K for Chien-Ming Wang. Here's Nick Ferdinand. Nick rounding out in his only at bat back in the first. Right-handed hitter. All the hype tonight around Chien-Ming Wang, a guy who is one of the biggest signings in the Atlantic League here this season. Slowly into the wind, here's the pitch. Taken a little bit high with a fastball. And he hasn't disappointed either. Anthony LaRue on the other side, starter for the Revolution, has done a nice job as well. Wang started the season in AAA Gwinnett in the Braves organization. The pitch. Swing and a little pop-up. Left side of the infield behind third Stevenson. 2 feet on the outfield grass. Makes a one-hand catch. Two up, two down. Bases empty. Here's Andres Perez. Wong was released by the Braves on June 19th. Signed just a couple of days ago by the Blue Crabs. With the Braves, he was 2-6 with a 5.53 ERA. Righty on righty matchup. Perez, the second baseman, the pitch. Swing and a line drive out to short. Gloved on one bounce by Frawley on the back edge of the dirt. And makes the long throw to first in time. And Perez is out number three. Seven straight retired by Chien-Ming Wang. We're through 3.5 here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Revolution Blue Crabs are scoreless on the Etrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. At Capital Area Orthopedics Associates, their mission is to deliver quality care to families and individuals. They strive to help every patient understand their trauma, disorder, or disease, as well as providing available options to treat their medical problems. At Capital Area Orthopedic Associates, our primary focus is to take care of the patient. Call 301-392-3330 or visit CapitalAreaOrtho.com today. That's CapitalAreaOrtho.com today. Zach Wilson will lead things off, bottom fourth, on the Etrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Thanks to those watching on the YouTube side of things as well. It'll be Wilson Molina Ward. 3-4-5, Wilson doubling his first time. LaRue, the righty into the wind. Here's the pitch. Down the way. Anthony, his fourth inning of work. He has struck out two batters in the ballgame. The pitch. Swing and a pop foul straight back over the screen. And that's out of play. One ball, one strike is the count. Blue Crabs looking to win the series. Separate themselves further in the standings. 1-1. Low and away. Now it's two balls and one strike. Southern Maryland coming in with a record of 33-25. Good for first place in the Freedom Division. Five games up on second place Sugarland. 2-1 swing and a soft liner out toward short to his left. Gloving it on one bounce. Patterson throws to first near the bag. It's in time. Nice play by Eric Patterson. Had to range all the way to his left and glove that one on one bounce. And Wilson robbed of a hit. It was a jam shot. That fastball got in on the hands of Zach. But a fine, fine play by the veteran Eric Patterson, who was actually playing second base last night. This is a very good infield for the Revolution. Here's Gustavo Molina. And the pitch. Swinging a foul back to the screen. I say that because it's Valdez at third. He can play short or second. Patterson at short, same thing. Perez, very good hands at second base. And then Nash is a pretty good fielding first baseman. The pitch to Molina. Swinging a fly ball into shallow left. Ferdinand coming on. Jogging to the spot. Makes the catch. Quickly two up, two down. Molina's 0 for 2. Here's Darrell Ward, who is 0 for 1. With a ground out to the first baseman, Nash, back in the second. LaRue's last start came on the 20th at Lancaster. Not factor in the decision. Went six innings, allowing three runs on four hits. Ward the DH. Bases cleared. Two outs, bottom four, no score. LaRue, 32 years of age, 14th professional season. Patterson, the shortstop, pinch towards second. The pitch, and a fastball high. LaRue began the 2014 season with Revolution, but pitched very well, 1-0. Taken for a called strike. I say but because he earned a contract with the Angels, where he spent the remainder of the 2014 season in their farm system in AAA Salt Lake. 1-1. Down low. In case you're wondering, he went 1-1 with a 2.25 ERA over five starts and led the Atlantic League with 24 strikeouts in 24 innings right before he was signed by LA. Here's the next offering low. Now it's 3-1 with Jake Opitz waiting in the on-deck circle. Nobody on base. Valdez towards the hole on the left side, away from his third base position. 3-1 offering. Swing and a mile-high fly ball, shallow left. Three men converging. Patterson back from short. Called off by Ferdinand, the left fielder, who makes a one-hand catch. So the Blue Crabs are set down in order. 1-2-3. Moving right along here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Quick-moving game tonight. We head to the top of the fifth. We're scoreless. Revolution in the Blue Crabs. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Top of the fifth inning here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Scoreless game, Revolution and the Blue Crabs moving right along here in Southern Maryland. Jacob Calderon will lead things off the DH. Chien-Ming Wang has retired 7 straight hitters. The right-hander into the line. Here comes the pitch. Swing and a line drive into left, and there's a base hit. First hit for the Revolution since the top of the second inning as Calderon, the DH, now 2-for-2. He's got 2 singles. Here is Telvin Nash. Revolution overall with 3 hits here tonight. Wong does have 1 strikeout, 35-year-old. Wong went 2-6 in the International League. Pitched at both the Major League and the Minor League level. Nash, right-handed hitter. The pitch in tight at the belt. We mentioned Nash, 3-for-23 coming into the game now, 4-for-24. If you're the Revolution, you want to get this guy going. Former third-round draft pick by the Astros in 09 out of Griffin High School in Griffin, Georgia. 1-0. Cut on, foul tip held by Molina behind the plate. This guy with a lot of power, though. Speaking of Nash, 102 home runs since his professional debut in 2009. You know, he's a big kid, 6'1", 230 pounds. He can easily take advantage of that short porch and left, 310 from home plate down the line. As Wong comes set, the 1-1. Swung on, dribbled foul, third base side towards the dugout. Now 1-2 is the count. No score, top of the fifth, nobody out. Calderon singled, he's at first. On deck is Salvador Paniagua. Hope it's second. Relatively big hole on the right side. Outfielders play straight away. Wong comes set at the letters. 1-2 pitch. In the dirt, blocked by Molina nicely using the chest protector. 2-2 is the count. I mentioned that Wong was a guy who finished second in the Cy Young Award voting in 2006 behind Johan Santana. 19 wins in 06 and 07. But he suffered a foot injury on June 15th of 08, running the bases in Houston against the Astros in an interleague game. The 2-2 pitch, cut on, foul tip at the plate, and that injury hurt that 2008 campaign form. Same thing in 09, he just wasn't really the same, and then that injury also cost him the 2010 season. And because of that foot injury, he was overcompensating a little bit with his arm, trying to use too much of his arm and not as much of his lower body as he was used to in the past. 2-2, runner breaks for second, a swing and a miss. Molina's throw to second. Here's the tag, out at second base. Opitz covering the bag, applying that swipe tag on the line drive throw, a bullet throw from Gustavo Molina from behind the plates. Strike him out, throw him out. 2 outs. Nobody on base. Here is Salvador Paniagua. Two strikeouts in the game for Wong. Paniagua, the catcher. Bats from the right side. Here's the pitch. Taken for a called strike, clipping the outside corner. Wong pitching really well here tonight. He's allowed just 3 hits. And the 35-year-old in his first start here in the Atlantic League. He deals a little bit low with the next offering, a fastball. And it's 1-1. Great crowd on hand here tonight as well. It's halfway to Christmas night here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Lights are on, overcast skies above. Wind picks up at the ballpark. 1-1 pitch. Swung on, bounced slowly towards third. Stevenson charges, gloves on the grass. Off balance, throw to first. Wilson pulled off the bag, and his tag attempt is too late. The safe call by Christopher Kiersarski, the first base umpire. We'll see how they score it. That throw a little bit high. Wilson was pulled off the bag, and then he stepped back behind the bag into foul ground. Tried to apply that tag, but I guess from here it looked like he was out. As Stan Clyburn's out of the dugout, and he is arguing his case here, and he's heated. He already was arguing with Donald Mayer when Jamar Walton was thrown out at home plate. He disagreed with that call, and now he disagrees here with Christopher Kiersarski, who's just standing there, stone-faced, letting Stan rant. clock is ticking here. How much longer will Christopher Kiersarski keep his hands in his pockets before he ejects Stan?
Touch him.
Stan is really fired up. Christopher Kiersarski not giving him anything. Stan was almost finished. He started to walk away. And that's it. He's not ejected. Gave him the peace of his mind. And now he's going to walk back to the third base side dugout. And he's got a couple more words for Donald Mayer, the home plate umpire as well. I'm sure a lot of I disagree with yous and a lot of bleeps were in there. Stan gets a nice ovation from the Blue Crabs faithful. Two out base runner. It is a hit, by the way, for the Revolution. They've got four hits here in the game, and the batter is Sean Smith. Along with the set, two outs. Here's the pitch. Swing and a hot shot, deep short. Frawley in front of it. Off-balance throw to second is in time as he fell down to his backside on the back edge of the dirt to make that play. Opitz covering the bag for the force out. And that does it for the Revolution. No runs, two hits, and one man left. To the home half of the fifth inning here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Revolution and Blue Crabs are scoreless on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Jake Opitz walking to the home plate area. He'll lead things off. Bottom of the fifth inning. Scoreless game. The Revolution and the Blue Crabs. Rubber matchup of this three-game set. Doubleheader last night. Blue Crabs winning the first ball game 8-3. And the second ball game belonged to the Revolution by a count of 5-1. Anthony LaRue's first pitch is outside. The right-hander beginning inning number 5. He's done a nice job here tonight with all the hype with Chien-Ming Wang, 1-0. A change up for a called strike thigh high. Well, LaRue has pitched 4-plus innings. He's allowed just two hits, and he has struck out two batters. The pitch. Opitz takes in the dirt. Jake 0-for-1 with a fly out to straightaway center. Opitz returning to the lineup May 28th. He missed 18 games with an oblique injury. He's in his eighth professional season. Ready on lefty, the pitch. Swing and a line drive to right. Wilkerson charging in, slows down, and makes a two-hand catch in stride. Hope it's hitting that one right on the nose as Wilkerson was able to run it down. That'll send Javon Rosa to the plate. Cedar Point Federal Credit Union has been around since August of 1945, offering commitments to service, education, member involvement, equal opportunity, community, and credit union movement. To learn more, visit www.cpfcu.com. Cedar Point Federal Credit Union, the one place to go. Here's the pitch to Rosa, taken for a called strike over the outside. Rosa struck out looking his first time. The pitch. Swing and a looper, a shallow right. Wilkerson sprinting in. It touches down, a base hit. Rosa singling, third hit of the ball game for the Blue Crabs. Before that, LaRue retired five straight. One out base runner, scoreless game, bottom of the fifth. And with one out, here is Jamar Walton. Jamar doubling his first time back in the third inning. Righty on lefty pitch. There's a fastball strike over the outer third. Walton, 29 years of age. The pitch. Breaking ball, a little bit high. One ball and one strike. He was drafted by the Florida Marlins, who were the Florida Marlins at the time, in the fourth round of the 04 draft. Spent seven seasons in the Marlins, Royals, and Nationals organization. Made it as high as the high A level. Here's a fastball a little bit low, and now it's 2-1. Here in 2015, he's been very valuable. And he's a guy who, as I mentioned, very athletic, can play all three outfield positions. He's batted at the bottom of the order. He's done a nice job. So quick throw to first. And Rosa diving back in head first safely and momentarily skips away from Nash near the coach's box. Telvin picking it up, calling time here. He'll jog the baseball back to LaRue. Walton has had his success at the plate this season. Not only is he hitting .310 his last 10 games, he also owned a seven-game hitting streak from May 20th to June 2nd. 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, way ahead of a changeup. Nice pitch from LaRue, who's got good stuff. He works quickly again. He's got that quick windup. And he's got a good fastball and some good off-speed stuff. Two balls, two strikes. Pitch on the way. That's low, a fastball, full count. LaRue signed with the Nippon Professional Baseball League in Christmas of 2010. He was signed to play in that league in 2011. Runner breaks for second, and a 2-2 swing and a dribbler foul to the backstop. Rosa got a good jump off first, but anyway, in March of 2011, if you'll remember, in Japan, the earthquake struck, a big time earthquake, registered at 9.0. And while his team was about 600 plus miles away, 3-2, runner breaks for second again, and that one is bounced foul of first. When he went to the store right after the earthquake to get some food, there was nothing there but waters and stores, because there was food and even water being shipped to the people who were south of where he was, about 630 miles away. And of course, 2 days later, a volcano erupted, and LaRue and his teammates were out practicing in their spring training attire with ash raining down on the field. Steps off the backside of the rubber and quickly whips his head around to first here, but quite an experience for him in 2011. We want to talk about a life experience, an earthquake and then a volcano. 3-2, Rosa breaks for second. The pitch is low, that's ball four. And Jamar Walton drawing the walk. A hit, a walk, first and second, one out. Here is Casey Frawley. And think about LaRue, you know, he was in a different country having to deal with these elements. And while it didn't affect him directly, you know, still when you go to the store and you're trying to find some water or food, I don't care what country you're living in, and you only find water, your back's a little bit up against the wall. Not that, of course, water is anything less, but still, here's Casey Frawley in the pitch. Swinging a foul off the mask of Peniagua. It was a scary time, but it was certainly a time that LaRue will never forget. LaRue checking on his catcher, Salvador. Nothing in one, the count. Blue Crabs and the Revolution are scoreless here in the bottom of the fifth. Blue Crabs have won 4 of 5, looking to take this three-game set before they hit the road. They will take on the Patriots in a three-game set this weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then a five-game series against the Bridgeport Bluefish. Here's an 0-1 swing and a hot shot to short. Off the glove of Patterson. Patterson ricochets out to left field. Everybody moves up the bag as Patterson picks it up about 7 feet behind his shortstop position. And it should be a single. It will be a hit for Casey Frawley as he hit that ball very sharply on the ground. It would have been a tough play for Patterson, who tried to slide to his right and make a backhand pick. Bases are loaded, two hits in the inning, including a walk by Walton, or to Walton, I should say. And here is Fred Lewis with an RBI chance. Fred was up with Walton at third base back in the third inning. Jamar was thrown out after the ground ball was hit to second base by Lewis. Here's a swing and a hot shot to second, knocked down by Perez. Tries to pick it up on the cut of the grass, unsuccessful, and scoring from third is Rosa. And the Blue Crabs take a 1-0 lead, and the bases are still loaded. That was a racket off the bat of Fred Lewis. He's hit the ball hard here tonight. And the Blue Crabs, with that 1-0 lead, finally cracking the scoreboard here in the bottom of the fifth. Here's Casey Stevenson. Stevenson bats from the left side. He's 0-2. The pitch. Casey takes high. It is a hit, by the way. We just got confirmation. It is a hit and an RBI for Lewis, his 17th RBI of the year. Blue Crabs with three hits here in the inning. Base is still loaded. Walton's at third. Frawley's at second. Lewis at first. The pitch. A changeup outside. Then it's 2-0. The set position, the pitch, cut on, a foul tip at the plate. Outfielders play straight away, infielders at their normal positions. Stevenson hitting .333 with runners in scoring position, .250 with bases loaded this year. On deck, Zach Wilson. It doesn't get any easier for LaRue after Stevenson. Nobody loosening down the right field line of the bullpen. One out, bottom five, here's the pitch. Swing and a miss right off the glove of Peniagua, who picks it up quickly behind the home plate area right on the cut of the grass. And it's 2-2 here to Casey Stevenson. Now I've just been informed that a quick scoring change. It is an error on Perez. So an error on the second baseman Andres, his sixth of the year. Either way, base is still loaded for the Blue Crabs. One out, 1-0 lead. Bottom five, the 2-2. Swing and a hot shot. Base hit right through a hole on the right side. Walton scores from third. Frawley's being waved around third. The throw to the plate is too late from Wilkerson as it's knocked down on one bounce by Peniagua. Two-run single for Casey Stevenson. The Blue Crabs take a 3-0 lead. Fred Lewis moving up to third base, and Casey Stevenson, RBIs number 24 and 25. Here's Zach Wilson, time called, and Salvador Peniagua up to talk with Anthony LaRue, trying to settle down the starting pitcher, who up to this point was throwing really well through all the hype of Chien-Ming Wang. LaRue kind of went under the radar and was pitching well, but the Blue Crabs here in the bottom of the fifth have scored three runs on three hits. Rosa started the rally with a single. He later scored. Walton walking, he scored. Frawley singling, he scored. Lewis reaching on the error by Perez. Stevenson with a two-run single. Here's a swing and a foul by Wilson back to the screen behind the plate. Zach, right-handed hitter. He doubled back in the first. He's 1-2. One out. Starts to drizzle here at the ballpark. Want to get this half inning in. The 0-1. A called strike over the outside corner. LaRue from the stretch. Inside target, 0-2 swing, and a bouncer foul outside of third. A nice snag by Jeremy Owens, the third base coach. Ran the coach's box. That was that was pretty. He was an outfielder, by the way, here with the Blue Crabs and in the Rays organization. He was not an infielder, but that was a very nice athletic play. Nothing in two, one out. 3-0 Blue Crabs. A three spot here in the fifth. The pitch outside. Check swing on the appeal. No swing. Christopher Kiersarski, the call, the first base umpire. He's had his disagreements tonight with manager Stan Clyburn. As a baseball from the bullpen down the right field line, comes into the field of play. Stan has also had some contention with home plate umpire Donald Mayer as well. Blue Crabs, three runs here in the fifth, the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Down goes Wilson for the strikeout. Third strikeout for LaRue here tonight. Here's Gustavo Molina. Eighth hitter to come to bats for the Blue Crabs here in the bottom of the fifth. Three runs on three hits. The pitch. Swinging a foul back to the screen. Blue Crabs with five hits overall here in the ballgame. Molina's 0 for 2 with a pair of flyouts. Lewis at third, takes his lead in foul ground. Stevenson drove in two runs with a single as at first. Inside target, the pitch. In tight, and Molina turning away as it's one ball and one strike. You'd have to imagine that with the numbers Molina has put up this year, tied for first in the league with those 9 home runs, 5th in RBIs, and 2nd in the Freedom Division with that batting average coming in, he'd be the starting catcher for the All-Star game. Here's a 1-1 wave and a miss as he was fooled on a pitch that was off the outside corner. Temperature has dropped a little bit here at the ballpark. A drizzle coming down from the gray sky up above. One ball, two strikes. The smell of hot dogs throughout the ballpark. Two outs, 1-2. Cut on, foul tip, roller to the backstop. Again, there is bullpen activity down the right field line for the Revolution. Smith, the center fielder, a smidge towards the right center field gap. Here's the set. And the runner breaks for second. Here's a 1-2 foul back to the backstop. Stevenson got an early, early jump. I'm a little bit surprised I didn't hear Telvin Nash, the first baseman, say, step off, in a very loud tone. You hear that oftentimes with first baseman when the runner breaks very early, as Stevenson did there. See if Casey's off again. He is not. 1-2. Just missed off the outside corner. Some of the infielders started to walk off the field. So did LaRue. Donald Mayer not giving him the call. Two balls, two strikes. Two outs, 3-0 Blue Crabs, bottom five. Blue Crabs have won 4-5. 7-3 in their last 10. 2-2 pitch. Cut on, foul tip into the mitt of Peniagua, and Molina is down on strikes. Blue Crabs putting up a three spot. Three runs on three hits. One Revolution error, and runners left at the corners. At the end of five innings of play, it's Southern Maryland 3 and York nothing. This is the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network.
St. Charles coming. Thanks for coming out. Thank you.
Community Bank of the Chesapeake serves the Tri-County with personal service, financial solutions, while building warm and meaningful relationships. Get to know what they have to offer today. Log on to www.cbtc.com or call 888-745-2265. Chien-Ming Wang, sixth inning of work. He's got a 3-0 lead. Blue Crabs, three runs in the bottom of the fifth inning. 9-1-2, Valdez, Wilkerson, Patterson due up. Wong, the right-hander, ready to work. Slowly winds up. Here's the pitch. And Valdez takes a little bit low. So Wong, six-plus innings. He's allowed just four hits and striking out two. Valdez grounding out to the second baseman. Opitz his first time. 1-0 offering. Taken for a called strike over the inside corner. Time now for our Blackstone Management out-of-town scoreboard. As we always do, we will start in the Atlantic League, Clipper Magazine Stadium. Bottom of the fifth, the Patriots and the Barnstormers tied at two. 1-1 pitch. Swing and a bouncer towards the middle. Frawley to his left, flags it down. Spins on the outfield grass. Throw to first is offline, pulling Wilson off the bag. Nice play by Frawley to snag that one, but throw offline. Valdez, good speed, probably would have beat it out anyway. It's a leadoff infield single for Wilson, and the fifth hit of the ball game for the Revolution. Back to the top of the order, and here is Shannon Wilkerson. The Patriots coming into the night, 43 wins, the most in the Atlantic League, first place in the Liberty Division. Top of the fifth inning at Harbor Yard in Bridgeport, the River Sharks and the Bluefish playing tonight in Bridgeport. Camden with a 6-1 lead. Those two teams in the bottom of the Liberty Division. A little bit low. Fastball didn't miss by much. That ball game in the top of the fifth. And the only other ball game tonight in the Atlantic League, Constellation Field in Sugar Land, Texas. The Ducks and the Skeeters are scoreless. Bottom of the first, that ball game just getting underway. Long comes set. The pitch. Runner breaks for second. The fastball low. Molina's throw to second. Here's the tag. Out at second base. And Valdez has contention with third base umpire Kevin Sweeney. Second time tonight that a base stealer has been thrown out at second base by Gustavo Molina. That throw on a short hop with Frawley covering the bag, applying the tag. And Wilson Valdez is erased. Here comes Mark Mason, and he has a couple of words for Kevin Sweeney. Mark, in his third season as the manager for the Revolution, talking things over here with Kevin Sweeney. Very, very unhappy. But finishes his conversation and walks back to the first base side dugout. Mason led this Revolution team to 78 wins last year, the second highest total, in fact, in franchise history. It's been a rough go around here in the first half for his team, though. Bases empty, one out. 2-0 is the count here to Shannon Wilkerson, who is 0-2. He's grounded out, and he lined out softly to the second baseman, Opitz. The pitch. Taken for a called strike over the inside corner. Moving on to the Major League scoreboard on the Blackstone Management out-of-town scoreboard. Top of the second inning in Pittsburgh. The Pirates 40-31 on the year. Down to the Reds, 1-0. Reds 33-37. A.J. Burnett is pitching tonight for the Pirates. He's having a really good year. 2-1 offering. Down the way, now three balls and one strike. Top of the fifth, the Cardinals 47-24 on the year. Are beating the Marlins 1-0. Marlins 30-43, 13 games under 500. Dan Heron throwing tonight for the Marlins. Cardinals with four hits. Each team committing an error in that ball game. Long into the wind. He kicks. Here's a 3-1. Swing and a dribbler foul up the third base side. Full counts. Bottom of the first inning, Wong's former team, the New York Yankees, 39-33 on the year, are scoreless with the Houston Astros in Houston. The Astros 42-32. Adam Warren tonight is pitching for the Yankees. Astros are such an exciting team. They really are with that young talent. They've got guys, veterans like Jose Altuve this year, having another good year. I mean, another veteran guy there. And of course, Carlos Correa. So exciting to watch. Here's a 3-2 swing and a grounder just foul outside the bag at third. Rolling down the left field line. Eight games went final earlier today. The White Sox defeated the Tigers 8-7. Tigers 37-36 on the year. White Sox 32-40. That was a wild game. 26 hits between the two teams. Tigers with 16 hits. White Sox with 10. White Sox defeating the Tigers 8-7. Jabba Chamberlain, another former Yankee, took the loss. He's 0-2. 3-2 pitch. Swing and a bouncing ball slowly hit to third. Stevenson charging. Bare hands on the cut of the grass. Off balance throw to first. The stretch by Wilson, and it's in time. Nice play by Casey Stevenson. He's had to make a couple of bare-handed grabs here tonight. Two outs, bases empty. Here's Eric Patterson. Plays like that really get you excited when you're watching because they're done. They are, we'll say, easier said than done. I mean, they look a lot easier than what they actually are. It's one of those things where it is easier said than done. And Stevenson, a couple of bare-handed grabs here tonight. He's made it look easy. And it's almost like an art form when you do that. Mark Mason out of the first base side dugout again. More contention here with the first base umpire, Christopher Kiersarski, this time. He's finished. He walked back to the dugout. But yeah, Stevenson barehanding it, and then all in one motion, throwing it to first. Beautiful, beautiful thing. Here's Eric Patterson, two outs. Blue Crabs a 3-0 lead, top six. The pitch on the way. Taken high, ball one. Zach Duke picked up the win, by the way, in that White Sox-Tigers game. Robertson the save, his 15th, 1-0. Swing and a line drive back up the middle into center, and that's a base hit. Sixth hit of the ball game for the Revolution. Patterson's 1 out of 3. Here's Nick Ferdinand, who's 0-for-2. The Orioles defeated the Red Sox today 8-6. Orioles 38-34. 14 hits today. Red Sox with 12 hits. Now 10 games under 500 at 32-42. Miguel Gonzalez picked up his 6th win of the year. Eduardo Rodriguez took the loss. Zach Britton with his 21st save. Matt Wieters, his 3rd home run of the season. Deaza with a home run for Boston, his 4th. The pitch. Taken for a called strike across the knees. Elsewhere around baseball today, the Athletics defeated the Rangers 6-3. Both teams with 10 hits in that game. Teams were swinging the bat today. The Athletics 34-41, Rangers 37-36. Sonny Gray picked up his 10th win, making his 9th win of the year. Keon Kayla picked up the loss. Here's a bounding ball left side. Stevenson cuts it off to his left. The third baseman fires to first a little bit high, but Wilson catches and drops right back down onto the bag for the 5-3 putouts. No runs a hit, and one man left. We move to the bottom of the 6th inning. We'll continue with the scoreboard when we get back. The Blue Crabs 3. And the Revolution, nothing. You're listening to the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network.
Tonight's Community Bank and the Chesapeake Play
Over the past decade, Dashen has rapidly expanded in the mid-Atlantic region with over 45 franchises, operating more than 60 stores while selling convenience items with a wide variety of food and beverage choices. Stop into Dashen today. Darryl Ward will lead things off. We are in the bottom of the sixth inning. Southern Maryland with a 3-0 lead. Anthony LaRue begin inning number six. Here's the pitch to Ward. Darryl takes a called strike across the knees. Ward left-handed hitting DH, 0 for 2 in the game. Bullpen activity still evident down the right field line for the Revolution. 1-0 pitch. Breaking ball fouled straight back to the net. One ball, one strike. Continuing with the Blackstone management out of town scoreboard. The Mets defeated the Brewers today, 2-0. Mets with 10 hits. Brewers with just 4 hits. Jacob DeGrom picked up his 8th win of the year. He's 8-5 with a 2.15 ERA. Michael Blazek with the loss. Here's a swing and a bouncing ball. Right back to LaRue. Called foul, though. A little bit late by Donald Mayer, the home plate umpire. Might have got a piece of the foot of Darryl Ward. It's a ball and two strikes. Drew's Familia picked up his 20th save of the season. The Dodgers defeated the Cubs today 4-0 to win their 41st game of the year. 1-2. Swing and a line drive over the head of the leaping Perez. And into right field, a base hit. Blue Crabs with 7 hits here in the ballgame. Ward on base for the first time. And here's Jake Opitz, who's hitless in 2 at-bats. Cubs now 39-32. Carlos Frias picked up the win. He's 5-5. John Lester took the loss. He's 4-6 now on the season with a 4.03 ERA after signing that big deal in the offseason with the Cubs. Hope it's left-handed here in the pitch. And a fastball taken low. The Rockies defeated the Diamondbacks today 6-4. Rockies 32-40. Diamondbacks 35-37. Justin Miller picked up the win, his first of the year. Daniel Hudson dropped to 2-3 with the loss. Here's a breaking ball up and away. John Axford is 13th save. Nolan Arenado is 20th home run for Colorado. And Troy Tulowitzki also homering for the Rockies, his 8th of the year. The Giants beat the Padres today 13-8. Giants 40-34 on the year. Padres 35-40. 2-0. Swing and a miss. And it's 2-1. 19 hits for the Giants. 12 hits for the Padres today. Chris Heston picked up his 8th win of the year. James Shields took the loss. He's now 7-2 with a 4.24 ERA. Matt Kemp, homering today for San Diego, his 5th of the year. Ward the leadoff first. Here's a 2-1. Swing and a broken bat. Flare out to shallow center, and that's down for a base hit. Ward will stop at second. The barrel of the bat stops rolling on the right side of the infield on the grass. And back-to-back hits here for the Blue Crabs as they have solved what was a riddle of Anthony LaRue, who was pitching really well here but gave up those 3 runs. Bottom of the 5th inning, where the Blue Crabs sent 8 men to the plate. They scored 3 runs on 3 hits. Now they've got 2 hits here in a row. The bottom of the 6th. The batter is Jovan Rosa. Nobody out. 3-0 Blue Crabs as LaRue steps off the backside of the rubber. Still bullpen activity down the right field line here for the Revolution. Our final score on the Blackstone Management Out of Town scoreboard. The Washington Nationals defeated the Atlanta Braves today 7-0. Nationals 12 hits, 40-33 on the year. The pitch. Slider outside. Doug Pfister picked up the win, his third of the year. Matt Whistler took the loss. He's now 1-1 with a 3.75 ERA. Ian Desmond is sixth homer of the year. That does it for our Blackstone Management out-of-town scoreboard. And here at Regency Furniture Stadium, it's 3-0 Blue Crabs. Here's a bouncing ball foul outside of third, bouncing off the dugout fencing. Rosa, right-handed hitter. He's 1-for-2 with a single and a run scored back in the fifth. Ward is at second. He singled. Opens the trail runner at first. He also singled. Blue Crabs 7 hits in the game. Up 3-0, looking for more. 1-1. Breaking ball. Foul tip at the plate. Lights on here at the ballpark. The drizzle has stopped at this moment. Hopefully just a passing shower. Good crowd on hand here on this Thursday night in Southern Maryland. The 1-2. Down low, 2 balls, 2 strikes, and now you wonder how much more will Anthony LaRue go? LaRue approaching 100 pitches. He's thrown 96. The 2-2. Waved at and missed. Strike three. Down goes Rosa, and a big strikeout for Anthony LaRue. LaRue has 5 strikeouts here in the ballgame. And Jamar Walton will be the next hitter. Here comes manager Mark Mason. This may do it for Anthony. Mason will take the baseball. LaRue is finished. And we have a call to the bullpen. A pitching change for the Revolution. We're in the bottom of the sixth. First and second for the Blue Crabs with 1 out. Southern Maryland up 3-0. You're listening to the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Layson Septimo is the new pitcher for the Revolution. Septimo, 2-2 on the season, a 5.09 ERA. This is 26th game, 23 innings. Septimo has allowed 14 runs, 13 of them earned on 33 hits. Opponents hitting 330 off of the lefty. He's got a three-quarter arm slot. He's on relief for Anthony LaRue. Went 5 1/3, allowing 3 runs on 7 hits. Both runners on base, his responsibility. Blue Crabs up 3-0, bottom of the sixth. Jamar Walton, the hitter. And here's the pitch. Walton swings and fouls it straight back to the screen. Walton has been on base twice tonight. He doubled back in the third, and he walked and scored a run in the fifth. Darryl Ward led off the inning with a single. He's at second. Hope it's then singled. And he's at first. LaRue right now in line for the loss. He struck out 5 batters. Blue Crabs putting up a 3 spot in the bottom of the fifth, looking for more here in the sixth. Here's an 0-1. Taken high, and that time, Septimo came a little bit more over the top with his delivery. He last pitched on the 20th at Lancaster. allowing three runs, and he didn't record an out. He actually took the loss that night as well. The 1-1 pitch. Waved at and missed. Now a ball and two strikes here to Jamar Walton. Blue Crabs up 3-0, 3 runs, 7 hits. Revolution, 6 hits. Did not have any runs to show for it. They've also committed an error. Southern Maryland coming in, having won 4 of their last 5. And the 1-2 offering. In the dirt, smothered by Peniagua. Septimo has allowed a run in 5 of his last 7 appearances. He's come out to 5 innings, 8 runs on 10 hits. Upset at the belt, checks the runner and the pitch. In tight towards the hands of Walton, who jerks his body back. And it's a full count. Septimo, 6'1", 200 pounds. He's from the Dominican Republic. On deck, Casey Frawley. Payoff pitch. Check swing, little dribbler left side. Off the mound, Septimo. He gloves it and goes to third for the force out to get Ward. Nice job by Septimo, fielding his position. As he had to come off the mound to his right, gloving it on the grass. He flipped it overhand to get Darryl Ward. Opitz moves up to second. Two runners are still on base. 2 outs, here's Casey Frawley. Raleigh with a sack bunt in the third. And he drove in a run with a single in the fifth. Right-handed hitter. Here's the pitch. Up and away. Septimo appeared in 21 major league games for the White Sox in 2012. Struck out 14 hitters in 14 and a third innings pitched. One-oh pitch. Swing and a pop foul straight back over the screen and out of play. On deck, Fred Lewis. First and second for Southern Maryland with 2 outs. A 3-0 lead, bottom of the 6th. Wind picking up here at the ballpark. The drizzle, which was here about an inning and a half ago, has gone away. Lights are on. Great crowd on hand tonight in Southern Maryland. Finale of this 3-game set. The pitch, swing and a miss, and Frawley chasing a high fastball. It's 1-2. Casey 1-for-1 tonight, 11-for-22, including tonight at the plate, since he returned from the disabled list on June 18th. He also at times this year has battled an eye injury as well, which has blurred his vision when he's been up at the plate. 1-2. In tight as he lifts up the elbows away from that fastball. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. Blue Crabs, we've mentioned, have had guys who have been injured, guys who have been banged up. They haven't missed big chunks of time, with the exception of a couple of guys. But this is a Southern Maryland team that has had their fair share of injuries. 2-2 pitch. Swing and a fly ball, straightaway center field, medium depth. Smith going back on it, settles under, and makes a one-hand catch 25 feet from the track. Blue Crabs with back-to-back singles to start this half inning, but unable to do anything with it. No runs, 2 hits, 2 men left. And at the end of 6 innings of play, it's Southern Maryland 3 and York nothing. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid.
Thank you.
Blue Crabs come in having won four of their last five and are looking to take the rubber game of this three-game set. They're up 3-0, top of the seventh. One of the big stories of the ball game, the debut of Chien-Ming Wang. A ton of excitement around that all day long, and he has lived up to the hype. Six innings pitched. He's allowed six hits, zero runs, and he has struck out two batters. Andres Perez will lead things off. It'll be Perez, Calderon, and Nash. Here's the windup and the first offering. Taken for a called strike over the inside corner. Perez is 0 for 2 here in the game with a pair of groundouts to the shortstop, Frawley. Luke Crabb's 33-25 on the season. First place in the Freedom Division. Their magic number to clinch is six games, the 0-1. Down the way, and it's one ball and one strike. Southern Maryland, 3 runs on 7 hits. Revolution, 0 runs, 6 hits, 1 error. Luke Crabb's 3 runs in the bottom of the fifth inning, sending 8 men to the plate. Long on the first base edge of the rubber. Slowly kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. And it's 1 ball and 2 strikes. Revolution on the other side, last place in the Freedom Division, 21-38. Team that has struggled mightily here in the first half of the season. Here's the windup of the 1-2. Swing and a soft liner out to short. Frawley charges. He gloves it on one bounce. Throws to first off balance in time. Blue Crab's defense has shown up and has done a nice job here tonight. Perez 0 for 3 with the hat trick of groundouts to the shortstop, Casey Frawley. One out for Jacob Calderon, the DH, who is 2 for 2 with a pair of singles. You know, you think about a couple of times this year, pitchers making their debut for the Blue Crabs, whether it be in the beginning of the season or in the middle of the season, as the first offering is grounded slowly foul first base side. Those pitchers, for the most part, have gone about 4 innings, maybe 5 innings. That's it. Stan Clyburn kind of cuts them off. But with Wong, there's really no need to do that. There is no real length to this start here. You can just let him go out there and throw the 0-1. And a pitch down and away, or I should say even a lack of length with Wong, because you know what? He just pitched back on the 17th against the Louisville Bats. This is just another start in his mind, in his rotation. 1-1. Swing and a grounder foul, first base side off the front right foot of Calderon, who's hopping around in pain. The DH will try to shake that one off, but with Wong, he's just starting on his turn in the rotation, just now in a different uniform in a different league. Not factor in the decision in his last start as he went 4 innings, allowing a run on 8 hits. That was back on the 17th of June. Here's the windup, the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Along with 3 strikeouts in the ballgame. Calderon still walking back in pain to the first base dugout. 2 outs, nobody on. 3-0 Blue Crabs, top of the 7th. Here's Telvin Nash. Along on the first base edge, ready to work. 2 outs, the first pitch, inside. Wong, the fastest starter to 50 wins and 85 starts at the major league level since Dwight Gooden did it. 1-0 delivery. Swing and a bouncer towards third. Frawley gloving it on the backhand, hugging the line in fair ground. Throws to first, a little bit low and wide. And Nash is safe. Tough play for Frawley, firing that one just in foul ground after he gloved it in fair ground. He was just a couple of inches from that white chalk directly behind the third base bag. Here's Peniagua. with two outs and a runner at first base. Seven hits apiece for both of these teams. Nash is 2-for-3. Peñagua is 1-for-2. Yeah, with Wong. He won his 50th game at the major league level on April 22nd of 2008 against the White Sox. Inside target from Molina in the pitch. A swing and a miss. Right hand hitting Peñagua coming out of his shoes on that swing. Long from the stretch. Here's an 0-1. Down low. One ball and one strike. Two outs. And the Blue Crabs with a 3-0 lead. Stan Clyburn telling me before the game, it's just one game at a time. You don't want to think about that magic number, which looms large over the Blue Crabs. Their magic number is 6. The 1-1. Swing and a broken bat. Flare back up the middle. Glove by Opitz directly behind the bag. And the second baseman steps on that bag for out number 3. No runs ahead. One man left. And Wong, walking off the mound, is doing a great job here in his Blue Crabs debut tonight. We head to the bottom half of the 7th inning. It's the Blue Crabs 3 and the Revolution nothing on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. What happened?
I was saying 215 viewers right now.
I heard. Garrett told me.
It's crazy.
We are
killing it.
We're successful. That's what we are, Gregory. That's what
you
we
are. It's not me.
Well, it's all of us. It's something we can tout to certain management.
It's cool, man.
It is cool, yeah.
It's big.
Wong's pitching well, man. He's Wong's pitching well. He's good. He's
going to be gone in like 3 starts.
It's a shame. He's fun to watch. And he slows the game down. Like that LaRue guy throwing, he was like, boom, boom, boom. It's like, oh my God, I feel like I'm doing football.
I watch that and I'm like, that takes a crazy amount of balance to go that slow.
Yeah.
He like stands like this for so long.
Yeah, yeah. Don't want to get in her shot. Would you like to ask me about Wong after the game? Would you like to ask me about Wong after the game?
Sure, why not?
I'm the broadcaster for the team, so. Edward Paredes is the new pitcher for the Revolution. 3-0 Blue Crabs. We're in the bottom of the 7th. Fred Lewis will lead things off. Paredes, a 3.78 ERA. 16th game, 16 2/3 innings. Opponents hitting 273. Lefty-on-lefty matchup. Lewis is 0-for-3 in the game. Blue Crabs with 7 hits. Here's the pitch. Swing and a dribbler foul up the first base side. It'll be Lewis, Stevenson, Wilson. The Crabs have won 4 of 5. Here's the pitch. Lewis squares, stabs at it, and bunts it foul straight back. And it's 0-2. Braid is the third pitcher of the ball game. Layson Septimo went an inning. Anthony LaRue started. He's in line for the loss. He went 5 1/3. Allowing 3 runs on 7 hits, striking out 5. The pitch Waved at and missed. Down goes Lewis. And he is 0-for-4 in the ball game. That'll send Casey Stevenson to the plate. Blue Crabs, a team, in case you're wondering, hitting .294 as a club off left-handed pitching. That really hasn't stopped opposing managers here in the Atlantic League from throwing those lefties out there. They'd rather play the matchups and take their chances than get beat throwing a right-handed pitcher against, at times, would have been a very lefty-heavy lineup for Southern Maryland. Here's the pitch to Stevenson, and he takes outside another left-handed hitter. Casey's 1 out of 3 with a 2-run single in the fifth. He grabs those 3 runs in the fifth, sending 8 men to the plate. 1-0. Swinging a foul straight back to the net. I remember in the beginning of the season, this was, I think, early May, when Southern Maryland, I remember one night I was talking about it on the air, their first 6 hitters in the order were all left-handed. And that, of course, was because of injuries and whatnot. But either way, I mean, there was a ton of lefties in the order. 1-1. Up and in, now 2 balls and 1 strike. 1 out, and the Blue Crabs with a 3-0 lead. Obviously, it's a little bit more mixed now, but because of the injuries and guys coming and going, Stan Clyburn had to work with what he had. The 2-1. Taken for a called strike across the knees. You know what I do remember? It was right in that Sugarland series, May the 12th, the 13th, and the 14th, because those first 6 hitters in the order were all left-handed. That was when Kyle Hankard was on the DL with a concussion. He was a right-handed hitter. The next offering is a swing and a fly ball right center field. Wilkerson into the gap, and Shannon makes a one-hand catch in right center field, medium depth. Stevenson retired. He's 1-for-4. Here's Zach Wilson. Zach doubling back in the first. He's 1-for-3. Thanks for joining us tonight on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Intrepid, empowering business to communicate with clarity. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. And Wilson behind on a fastball. Lefty on righty. Base is clear, 2 outs. Bottom of the 7th, 3-0 Blue Crabs. And we thank those watching on the YouTube side of things as well. Wind picks up here at the ballpark in 0-1. Outside, a changeup. And it's 1 ball and 1 strike. Paredes, in his last appearance at Lancaster on the 21st of June, went 2 2/3. Striking out 2. Lefty a high set in the pitch. Outside, 2 balls and 1 strike. Fans, whether it's a charter, airport shuttle, or group tour, Dillon's Bus Service is the company that fulfills your transportation needs. Call Dillon's Bus Service today at 410-647-2321 or visit dillonsbus.com. The pitch, outside, 3-1. Here's a high set, the kick and the pitch. Swing and a miss. Wilson tied up on a fastball in the inner half. Full count, 3 balls, 2 strikes. The trio of Stevenson, Molina, and Wilson coming into the ball game. The top 3 hitters in terms of batting average in the Freedom Division. Stevenson at .307, Molina at .290, and the guy at the plate, Wilson, at .271. Here's a ground ball to third. Valdez scoops it up, shuffles the feet, slings to first. And the Blue Crabs are set down in order, 1-2-3. Moving on to the 8th inning, it's Southern Maryland 3 and York nothing. You're listening and watching on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Thank you. Top half of the eighth inning here at Regency Furniture Stadium. It's Southern Maryland 3 and York nothing. 7 hits apiece for both of these clubs. Sean Smith will lead things off. It'll be 8-9-1. Smith, Valdez, and Wilkerson. Smith, right-handed hitter. He's 0-for-2. Chien-Ming Wang ready to begin inning number 8. Wang into the wind. Here comes the pitch. Smith squares and is unable to pull back in time as he takes a strike. Might have been a strike anyway, as it looked like it caught the inside corner. Wang, 7-plus innings, 7 hits, 3 strikeouts, living up to all the hype that surrounded this Southern Maryland organization all day long here today. The 0-1. Taken inside, 1 ball, strike. The wind and the pitch. Swing and a foul tip at the plates. It was held by Molina. And it's 1 ball and 2 strikes. .78 pitches thrown by Wang up to this point. He's a guy that will throw a lot of strikes. Doesn't strike out many hitters. Again, he only has 3 strikeouts in the game. Here's a 1-2. Down the way, but he will throw a lot of strikes. He will get those ground balls. His career strikeout per 9 inning statistic is just under 5 at 4.9. That includes both the major leagues and the minor leagues. Looking for his 4th strikeout of the game here. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Lifts the leg and delivers home. Swing and a line drive left center field. Walton on the run into the gap, and Jamar makes a one-hand catch in stride. Smith hit it hard, but Walton runs it down, and Sean Smith is 0-for-3. Here's Wilson Valdez. Valdez, right-handed hitter. Former major leaguer squaring off here. Long pitch for the Yankees, the Nationals, and the Blue Jays for a combined 8 seasons. Here's the first offering. Taken for a called strike right down the heart of the plate. Valdez spent parts of 7 seasons with the White Sox, the Mariners, the Padres, the Dodgers, the Mets, the Phillies, and the Reds. A journeyman. Really a journeyman to the tee. The 0-1. Swing and a ball fisted foul out of play right side. Nothing in 2, 1 out. 3-0 Blue Crabs. We're in the top of the 8th. Valdez playing in a career-high 111 games with the Phillies in 2010. Along with that great balance, the 2-2. Swing and a looper foul. Right side out of play. Nice catch by a fan about 3 rows deep. Nobody loosing in the bullpen down the left field line. Comes an 0-2. Breaking ball, bounced foul outside of third. And past the bag, down the line, into the Blue Crabs bullpen. If Wang, you would think, could get the 1-2-3 inning, he'd be out there for the ninth. And that'd be almost a perfect way to follow the script of what has been an exciting day here at Regency Furniture Stadium, just in general. The 0-2. Swing and a hot shot to short past the diving Frawley and in the left center field for a base hit. Rosa cutting it off. Wilson on his way to second. Here's the throw, the tag, and Valdez is out. More words for Kevin Sweeney, the third base umpire. Here comes Mark Mason again out of the first base side dugout. Valdez trying to stretch a single to a double. Nice throw from Rosa, fielding it cleanly in the gap. It's a single. 7-4 on the putout. Opitz covering the bag, applying the tag. Two outs, bases empty. Here's Shannon Wilkerson. Mark Mason very close to Kevin Sweeney, talking things over with our crew chief. Third base umpire has heard it tonight a few times from Mark Mason. The entire umpiring crew has had their contentions with both Mark Mason and Stan Clyburn, and Mark Mason has been ejected from this ball game. Paul Fletcher, the pitching coach, will be the acting manager here. Mark Mason, who is relatively mellow when you talk to him, good guy, very informative, great baseball mind. But right now, he is really fired up. He's ejected. He will walk back across the outfield in left center, back beyond the mini monster and to the clubhouse area. Mark ejected. Back to the top of the order. Here's Shannon Wilkerson. The Revolution, a frustrating first half of the season, as we've mentioned. 21-38 on the season, fourth place in the Freedom Division. A team that at times has struggled offensively. They've struggled defensively as well. Things just have not gone their way at all this year in the first half. Wilkerson, the batter, he's 0-3. Mason is now beyond the mini monster. Rosa's deep in left. Wilkerson's a right-handed hitter. Two outs, bases empty. Back to baseball, 3-0 Blue Crabs. The pitch on the way. Taken for a called strike at the knees. You know, this was a Revolution team that while they've struggled here in the first half of 2015, they're tied for second place back on the 30th of May. They just have had a bad month of June. The 0-1. Swing and a bouncer towards third. Gloved on the backhand. Directly behind the bag by Stevenson. He sets and fires across. And it's in time. How about this? For the month of June, the Revolution 6-18. It has been a frustrating month for York, to say the least. They're set down in order. 1-2-3. Home half of the eighth inning. It is Southern Maryland 3 and York nothing on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Charlotte Hall Veterans Home, celebrating its 30th anniversary, is focused on caring for Maryland's veterans and their spouses in an environment focusing on individualized services to enhance their quality of life. Charlotte Hall Veterans Home provides an assisted living and skilled nursing home for a long-term care facility for Maryland veterans and eligible spouses who are unable to take care of themselves due to their age or disability. Located at 29449 Charlotte Hall Road in Charlotte Hall, Maryland, Charlotte Hall Veterans Home provides top service standards. For more information, call 301-884-8171 or visit charlottehall.org. That is charhall.org. The new pitcher is Bo Vaughn, the right-hander. On a relief for Paredes, it'll be Molina to lead things off, and Gustavo takes a called strike. Molina's 0-for-3 in the game. Molina Ward opens. Vaughn 1-1, his 13th appearance, an ERA over 7. An 0-1 swing and a flare foul. First base side and out of play. Opponents hitting 333 off Vaughn this season. Anthony Alou started the game, and the right-hander went 5 1/3, allowing 3 runs on 7 hits. Right now he is in line for the loss. And on the other side, the big story of the ball game, Chien-Ming Wang. The pitch. Slider, got him looking. Strike 3 right over the outside corner. Molina down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Here's Darryl Ward, who's 1 out of 3. Wang, 8 innings pitched. 8 hits allowed, no runs, 3 strikeouts. Blue Crabs a 3-0 lead. They've won 4 of 5. Looking to win this series before they hit the road for an 8-game road trip. 3 against Somerset, and then 5 against Bridgeport. They will play a doubleheader on July 1st, that Wednesday, against the Bluefish. Here's a fastball strike over the outside corner. You'll remember that they were scheduled to play the Bluefish June 3rd, the 4th, the 5th, and the 6th, but they had 2 rainouts here at Regency Furniture Stadium. The 0-1. A called strike, and the series was cut down to 3 games instead of 4. So that 4th game was moved to the road, and it was scheduled for July 1st in Bridgeport. That doubleheader will be at noon, and then 7:05. Outside with a changeup, now 1-2. Blue Crabs then will return home to take on the Sugar Land Skeeters, the 3rd, the 4th, and the 5th. Should be a fun holiday weekend here in Maryland. The 1-2. Swing and a drive. Deep right center field. Wilkerson going back into the alleyway to his right. And Shannon makes a one-hand catch just shy of the track. Ward hit one very deep last night. That was tracked down on the warning track in right field, about 5 feet from the wall. And here tonight, Wilkerson tracking that one down. And Ward just getting under that one a little bit as well. Remember, it's very deep to right field from about left center field all the way over to the corner and right. It is huge here at the ballpark. Here's Opitz in the first offering. Is a called strike across the knees. Blue Crabs a 3-0 lead. We're in the bottom of the 8th. Nobody loosening in the bullpen down the left field line. The 0-1. A changeup outside. Unless I completely miss something, we will see Chien-Ming Wang going for the complete game in the 9th. The pitch inside. 1-2. The pitch. Swing and a hot shot. Base hit in the right center field. Just to the right of second, as Smith fields it cleanly in the gap. Opitz with the 8th hit of the ball game for the Blue Crabs. He's a 2-out base runner. Here's Jovan Rosa. Rosa walking slowly to the plate. Right-handed batter. Rosa's 1-for-3. The pitch. Taken a little bit low. Runner breaks for second. A called strike over the outside corner. No throw. And Opitz steals the bag. Jake with his third stolen base of the year. Blue Crabs a 3-0 lead here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Last night, just 5 hits offensively in game number 2. Here tonight, 3 runs in the bottom of the fifth. 1-1. Swing and a flare foul, first base side. And over the dugout, out of play. The combination of that 3-run fifth and the phenomenal pitching tonight by Wang has been the difference. Time called. Rosa steps out, steps right back in. One, two. Swing and a miss. Down goes Rosa. And that does it for the Blue Crabs here in the bottom of the eighth. They leave a runner in scoring position. We head to the top of the ninth. Last chance coming up for the Revolution. The Blue Crabs with a 3-0 lead on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Three runs in the fifth, and great pitching from Chien-Ming Wang in his Blue Crabs debut is the difference. Blue Crabs a 3-0 lead, top of the ninth, and Wang is going for the complete game. 8 innings, he's allowed 8 hits, and he has struck out 3 batters. It'll be Patterson, Ferdinand, Perez, 2-3-4 in the order. Patterson, 1 out of 3, left-handed hitter. Wang slowly winds and fires. And Patterson takes low with a fastball. Wang made his major league debut April 30th of 2005 with the New York Yankees at age 25. 1-0. Swinging a foul back and out of play towards the third base side. He pitched against the Toronto Blue Jays that night, going 7 innings, allowing 6 hits, not factoring in the decision. Here's the windup and the 1-1. Down and in, 2 balls and 1 strike. He's going for the complete game here tonight. His last complete game against the Boston Red Sox back on April 11th of 2008. Allowed a run on just 2 hits, the 2-1. Swing and a ball beaten into the ground, foul at the plate. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. 7 years later, in Waldorf, Maryland, in a Blue Crabs uniform, Chien-Ming Wang, in his debut, going for the complete game. Guy who was just signed a couple of days ago, activated today. And he has looked so comfortable on that mound here tonight. The 35-year-old who was released by the Braves organization on June 19th, after He went 2-6 with an ERA over 5 in AAA Gwinnett. The 2-2. Down and in, full count. Cameras flashing from the photographers. The 3-2. Swing and a dribbler foul, first base side. Long in his career, has 5 complete games, 3 of them at the major league level. Slowly winds, kicks and delivers. Swing and a broken bat, looper. Foul ground, left side, slicing out of play and into the seats. As Stevenson gave it a look. There's bullpen activity down the left field line. Eric Hamrin loosening. It is a safe situation if Hamrin were to come in. Patterson, meanwhile, gets another piece of lumber. There was some rain earlier in the ballgame around the fifth inning, but that has stopped. It's cleared out. Lights are on. It's a gorgeous night. A couple of bubbles in the air being blown. Wind is blowing as well. Smell of popcorn still evident. And the 3-2. Swing and a fly ball, a mile high, medium depth left. Rosa underneath, comes 3 steps in, makes a 2-hand catch. Patterson 1-for-4, here's Nick Ferdinand. Ferdinand, the left fielder, 0-for-3. Who grabs up 3-0, we're in the top of the ninth. They scored their 3 runs in the bottom of the fifth. The pitch on the way. Ferdinand swings, and it's a line drive past the diving Stevenson. And in the left field, a base hit. Ninth hit of the ball game for the Revolution as the throw comes in to the left side. The batter will be Andres Perez. And he is 0-for-3. Again, Eric Hamrin still loosening down the left field line. Forgetting the dramatics for a second, Wong has thrown 95 pitches. Just keep that in mind. Here's a quick throw to first, and Ferdinand diving back in head first safely. While everybody is rooting for that complete game and what would be a great start to an Atlantic League career for arguably the biggest signing in 2015. You have to keep the pitch count in mind. One out, first offering. Down and away. Blue Crabs have won 4 of 5. Looking to expand on their 5-game lead in the Freedom Division. 33-25 on the season. Looking to clinch the first half in just a couple of weeks. And punch their ticket to the playoffs later on in the fall, in September. There's a 1-0 swing and a grounder foul of third. Luke grabs the 7-2 advantage over the Revolution this season. Wong comes set. Pitch on the way. Swing and a grounder foul of third. Southern Maryland hitting the road to take on the Patriots in a 3-game set this weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Matt Zielinski will throw tomorrow for Somerset. Darryl Thompson throwing for the Blue Crabs. Brian Baker on Saturday. And then Jake Hale on Sunday. Lucas Irvine and Randy Boone will throw for the Patriots on Saturday and Sunday, respectively. Here's a quick throw to first. Ferdinand back in with a head first dive safely to the back inside corner of the bag. Anthony LaRue on the other side started the ball game. It was pitching pretty well up until the fifth inning. The right-hander 5-1/3, 3 runs, 7 hits. He's in line for the loss. The 1-2. Down and away with a breaking ball. It's two balls and two strikes. With each pitch, it's getting a little bit more tense here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Wang with part of his jersey partially out of his pants. Comes set from the stretch. The 2-2 on the way. Just missed off the inside corner. Might have been a little bit high. Right-handed hitting Perez with a good eye. He's 0 for 3 with a hat trick. Three ground outs to the shortstop for Ollie. Three balls, two strikes, one out. You wouldn't think the runner Ferdinand would be off here. He means nothing. His team down 3-0, but you just never know. A high set. 3-2 pitch. Swing and a pop-up on the infield right around the mound. Just on the left side as Wang comes off and makes a two-hand catch on the grass, called off his third baseman, Stevenson. And there is two outs, a Revolution down to their final outs. And Wang is looking for his first complete game since April 11th of 2008 against the Boston Red Sox when he was a member of the New York Yankees. Here's Jacob Calderon, the DH. He's the last hope for this Revolution team, who are in danger of dropping to 21-39. Calderon is 2 for 3 in the game with a pair of singles. Left-handed hitter and the pitch. Swing and a foul straight back to the screen. He had a good cut on that one. A fastball in the inner half, fouling it straight back to the net. And it's 0-1. Top of the ninth, 3-0 Blue Crabs. Outfielders play straight away. The set by Wong. The wind is blowing. The 0-1. Check swing, and he went too far around, according to Donald Mayer, the home plate umpire. And he went closer to three quarters than 50-50. And now the Revolution down to their final strike. Nothing in two is the count. Two outs. The runner at first, Ferdinand, he singled with one out. Crowd clapping. Getting behind Wong. The 0-2. Up high with an off-speed pitch. And it's one ball and two strikes. It's really tough to decipher the off-speed pitches because Wang has a variety of pitches in his repertoire. 3-0 Blue Crabs, top nine, two outs. A high set from the stretch. The 1-2. Swinging a ground ball to third. Stevenson dives to his right, gloving it. Pops up, throws to first, a little bit low, and not in time as Calderon is able to leg it out. Perez moves up to second base. Make it Ferdinand moving up to second base. Two on, two out. Wang has thrown 100-plus pitches here as Molina is out to talk with Chien-Ming Wang. And loosening down the left field line is Eric Hamrin. And if Eric, remember, were to come in, it would be a save situation. The Revolution, meanwhile, have 10 hits in the game. Here's Telvin Nash. One swing of the bat, and guess what? We've got a tie ball game. So while Wang is looking for the complete game, Nash is looking to tie the game. Here's the pitch. Swing, and a ball beaten into the ground. Foul off the front left foot of Telvin, a right-handed hitter. And it's 0-1. Nash has a ton of power. Former third round pick by the Astros in 09. 103 home runs to his name in his professional career. He was signed back on the 16th of June. The 0-1. Swing and a dribbler foul, third base side. Now it's nothing in two. And once again, with two outs, the Revolution down to their final strike. 3-0 Blue Crabs. Wang leaning at the waist, arm dangling off his right side. Runners there, leads off first and second. The kick, the 0-2. Down and away, skips by Molina to left side. And runners moving up to second and third. That skipped towards the third base side. and past Molina, tried to knock it down. And the runner's reading it well, moving up to second and third, a base open. One ball and two strikes. Ferdinand is at third. Goldron is the trail runner at second. A high set. The 1-2 offering. Down low, 2-2. You begin to wonder if this is going to be the last batter here for Chien-Ming Wang. You really do. He's over 100 pitches. Eric Cameron loosening down the left field line in the bullpen. You really don't want to play with fire here. Tying run is at the plate. 3-0 Blue Crabs. The 2-2. Swing and a ground ball. Sharply hit but foul outside the bag at third. On deck is Salvador Paniagua. Some begin to rise here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Everybody clapping. The 2-2. Swing and a bouncer, foul of third. This Revolution team not going away quietly. And they're really battling Wong here in the ninth. A high set. The 2-2 on the way. Swing and a ground ball towards the middle. And it's through. Into center, a base hit. Ferdinand will score. Called around third. He will score, touching the plate. Two-run single for Telvin Nash. It's a one-run game, 3-2. Here comes Stan Clyburn. And that'll do it for Wong as Eric Cameron, the closer, will come out of the bullpen. Wong pitching phenomenally here tonight. He is in line for the win. An orthopedic sports and physical therapy call to the bullpen. Everybody rising to their feet, and he will get a standing ovation, well deserved. Chien-Ming Wang is finished here tonight. An orthopedic sports and physical therapy call to the bullpen. Two outs, the tying run on base. Blue Crabs a 3-2 lead on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Just a reminder, coming up after the game, it's the the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs post-game wrap-up show. Orthopedic sports and physical therapy call to the bullpen. Two outs. We are in the ninth inning. Two runs in for the Revolution. 3-2 Blue Crabs. Eric Cameron, the new pitcher. Paniagua the batter, and he swings and misses. Wong finished. Went for that complete game. Just couldn't get it. It's his longest outing of the season, though, as he went 8 2/3, allowing two runs on 11 hits, both runs earned, striking out three, the 0-1. A breaking ball strike. And just like that, the Revolution down to their final strike. Two runs on two hits. Here's the set. The 0-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Molina scooping the pitch in the dirt. Throws down to first. The ball game is over. And Eric Hamrin records the save. Wang picks up the victory in his first start in his Atlantic League career. Eric Hamrin, 14 saves now on the season. Chien-Ming Wang is the obvious story of the ball game, the player of the game. Coming up next, the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs post-game wrap-up show. The Blue Crabs victorious here tonight, taking the three-game set, winning 2 of 3 from the York Revolution, winning tonight by the final of 3-2. Back with the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs post-game wrap-up show on the Etrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Well, the ball game just got over in time because the rain has started to come down here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Thanks for joining us tonight. Welcome inside the Regency Furniture Southern Maryland Blue Crabs post-game wrap-up show. I'm Jim Tarabocchia. Our final score here tonight, the Blue Crabs defeating the Revolution to take game three of the set and win the series 2 out of 3. The final 3-2, Southern Maryland beating the York Revolution. Southern Maryland out hit tonight, 11-8. Blue Crabs 3 runs on 8 hits, 7 runners left on, while the Revolution 2 runs, 11 hits, 1 error, and 6 runners left on base. The winning pitcher was Chien-Ming Wang, making his debut tonight, while Anthony LaRue took the loss. Wang 1-0, LaRue 3-4 on the season. Eric Hamrin picking up his 14th save of the year. Time of the game, 2 hours and 33 minutes. 4,112 baseball fans saw Wang pitch beautifully here tonight. Chien-Ming Wang, in his debut, nearly pitched a complete game. It would have been his first complete game since April 11th of 2008, when he was a member of the New York Yankees against the Boston Red Sox. Wasn't meant to be, because he gave up 2 runs in the ninth inning, but he went 8 2/3, allowing 2 runs on 11 hits while striking out 3, and he did not walk anybody. He walked 0 Revolution hitters. Anthony LaRue, on the other side, suffered the loss. He went 5 1/3, allowing 3 runs on 7 hits while walking 1 and striking out 5. Eric Hamrin came into the ballgame in the ninth, and he got Paniagua to strike out swinging to pick up his 14th save of the year. The Blue Crabs scoring 3 runs in the 5th. It wasn't really an offensive fireworks show here tonight, but again, they scored 3 runs in the 5th inning as they sent eight men to the plate, while the Revolution nearly came back and tied it in the ninth, but they scored 2 runs, falling a run short. They scored 2 runs in that 9th inning, and then Eric Hamrin came in, shut the door to pick up the save. Now, again, the Blue Crabs, 8 men, came to the plate in the 5th inning. It all started with a Javon Rosa single with 1 out, followed by a Jamar Walton walk. Casey Frawley then singled to load the bases. The next hitter, Fred Lewis, hit one sharply to second. Perez bobbled it, and it was an error committed by the second baseman. That allowed Rosa to score. The next hitter, Casey Stevenson, with runners at first and second, second and third, drove in both of those runners with a 2-run single. The next two hitters struck out, but the Blue Crabs did their damage. Now, in the ninth inning, Wong going for the complete game, and he allowed the 2 runs on 3 hits as Ferdinand singled with 1 out, then flew out, and Calderon singled. Telvin Nash then came to the plate. He singled, and that drove in 2 runners, and that made it 3-2. Wong was finished. Eric Hamrin came in, shut the door with the save, with the strikeout of Paniagua. Offensively tonight for the Blue Crabs, again, it really wasn't an offensive fireworks show, but they got 2 RBIs from Casey Stevenson, who continues to swing a hot bat. He went 1-for-4 tonight. Zach Wilson went 1-for-4. Jake Opitz went 2-for-4. Darrell Ward with a hit. He was 1-for-4. And the bottom three in the order, Rosa, Walton, and Frawley, had 3 hits combined. 2 RBIs by Casey Stevenson and an RBI from Fred Lewis, who drove in that RBI, reaching on that error by the second baseman in the 5th inning. Now, on the other side for the Revolution tonight, they out-hit the Blue Crabs, 11 hits overall, as Eric Patterson went 1-for-4, Nick Ferdinand 1-for-4 with a run scored. Calderon went 3-for-4 with a run scored. Paniagua went 1-for-4. Wilson Valdez at the bottom of the order went 2-for-3. And tonight, 11 hits. But again, for this Revolution team, they were unable to get really anything going against Chien-Ming Wang. So again, 11 hits here tonight, but they fall in the ball game by the final of 3-2. Time now for our Toyota of Waldorf driver of the game, and it's an easy pick to Chien-Ming Wang. Wang went 8 2/3, allowing 2 runs on 11 hits, while striking out 3. He is our Toyota of Waldorf driver of the game. Toyota of Waldorf is a premier Toyota dealer of Waldorf, Maryland. Toyota of Waldorf is honored by its faithful clientele and dedicated to the top quality customer service. For more information, log on to toyotaofwaldorf.com or call 301-843-3700. Established in 2003, Crossroads Hospitality is privately owned and operated. The executive team brings 4 years of experience in hotel management, investment, new development, and profitability. Crossroads Hospitality, located at 11770 Business Park Drive in Waldorf. Crossroads Hospitality, where excellence is standard. Fans, visit Domino's Pizza, located at 371 Smallwood Drive in Waldorf today. Guardian Pest Services is locally owned and operated in Fredericksburg, Virginia, and has a dedicated staff that has been servicing Central and Northern Virginia since 1999. For more information, visit GuardianPestServices.com. Hearing Professionals Doctor of Audiology has 4 locations, including 1 in Waldorf. Hearing Professionals provides the highest quality of personalized and professional diagnostics, along with rehabilitative balance and hearing healthcare services, to maximize each individual patient's quality of life. Honest Exteriors has provided quality projects at honest prices. At Honest Exteriors, they use the finest quality materials and certified craftsmen to give you the great results as a great with a great price. Honest Exteriors, feel good about coming home again. Iron Workers Local Number 5 is a progressive union representing more than 1,000 iron workers in the Mid-Atlantic region, which includes journeymen, apprentices, and retirees. Their vision is to move the ironworking industry into the future. Ironworkers Local Union Number 5, building our nation's capital since 1901. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll give you some scores from around the Atlantic League on the Blackstone Management Out-of-Town Scoreboard, as well as some scores from around Major League Baseball. The Blue Crabs pick up the victory here tonight by the final of 3-2. This is the Etrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network and the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs post-game wrap-up show on the Etrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network.